everybody, and welcome to my review on Luke Skywalker's Luke's Landspeeder from A New Hope. This set is a Walmart exclusive, so you can only find this set at Walmart, which is pretty crazy considering that the previous Landspeeder that we got before this was also a Walmart exclusive, which is probably the only reason why I was able to find this set at Walmart. It'll retail you $20 in the United States, if not $19.37, I think. In my opinion, it's kind of overpriced, especially for only 149 pieces. You're not getting too much there, but I guess since it's like a store exclusive set, with store exclusive sets, they always try to hype up the price, which is pretty ridiculous in my opinion. But I guess that's just how LEGO rolls, and it's a pretty horrible way of rolling them because it could kill their company. So let's just get into the minifigures.
So we might as well start off with everybody's favorite. Luke Skywalker is the main, minifigure in the set because, you know, it's him and his Landspeeder. So, which means he is the main minifigure. It's pretty good quality. It's kind of weird that for the longest amount of portion, like, you've started out with, like, an okay Luke Skywalker, but then after that you went to a horrible Luke Skywalker minifigure, and after that a good one, and after that a bad one, and then now finally a good one, the best one. And he has a nice face print. They kind of went back to the one from 2010, just upgraded it and not make his chin look so weird. And he also has a secondary face. That was very hard to do that. My hands are kind of sweating. He's got some gray printing everywhere. His face isn't ugly like it was in 2014. He also has binoculars and some printing on the back. But it's a pretty great minifigure in my opinion. Really great to have him in the set. And yeah. Next up, we've got the Tusken Raider now. What he's got is kind of strange. It's supposed to be like a shotgun blaster, but I can't really tell. He's got some printing on the back. He's got a bunch of printing on his torso and his legs in the front. And he's got a really nice molded head. I'm really digging that. He looks way better than what we got from, 2002. With Anakin and the Tusken Raiders, and I don't know if this thing is the best, but definitely could be better. You know what I'm saying? Next up is Ben Kenobi. Now this is where I'm gonna start to get very ranty. Now I'm pretty sure you're all running, wait a minute, it's Ben Kenobi, how could you say that? Well, here are my problems. First off, my biggest problem, the jacket, instead of just a cape jacket like we got in 2013, which is a much better minifigure, the best version of Ben Kenobi we have ever, that version had a cape. This has printed on it, and it looks absolutely bad and ugly, especially when you put a hoodie on him. It looks weird. Hoodies look weird, especially without capes, and that's probably a really big sin. Another big sin is that if you're gonna print it on his body, at least have it continue to the side and the back. But they didn't even do that. At least with the LEGO Star Wars cartoon, they at least printed on the side and the back. My next sin, they're still using that freaking hairpiece. They should use something, at least maybe a new printed piece, something shorter, because Obi-Wan's hair is not that long. It'd be great if it was that long, but it's not, so it's inaccurate. Now, don't get me wrong, I love his face print, but there's not even a secondary face. Like, Obi-Wan has more than just a happy face in the movie. Come on. We've only gotten a happy face from Ben Kenobi in the entire Ben Kenobi minifigure. So, that's really bad. And overall, it's just a really bum of a minifigure, and I just wish that they would just, I don't know, stick with the 2013 style, and instead just, like, maybe, You could keep the face, but at least have more than just a happy face and just cape and all that. And it's a huge setback, and for some reason they still use it to this day. There's gonna be an Imperial landing craft, I think, a sand craft, and it's gonna have this minifigure in it. And they still keep the same face expression, just Next up is C-3PO. Sorry about that. It's about to get blurry or whatever, because I literally had to spend like freaking 10 minutes just to get the camera set up to review this minifig because it was so blurry. He's got printing on the back, no printing on the side or legs, which is actually a pretty big step backward, especially considering that the 2015 C-3PO minifigure actually had printing on the arms and the legs. This is 2016, even though set is 2017, and C-3PO is just the same as he always is. Molded head, good printing on the front and the back. And yeah, he hasn't changed a bit, and I really don't see the reason why.
Now let's move on to the actual set. Now, in my opinion, the set was just a little bit, not completely, but just a little bit pointless to make, especially considering that in 2014, we have the exact same model of this set for the Cantina set. So that was kind of pointless, but either way, it's still a pretty good set. I just don't see the reason why the set is $20. I just wish they would put it to 15, especially considering it's only 149 pieces, no exclusive minifigures, and it's just the same remodel as what we got in 2014. I'm not saying this is a bad model, it's pretty good, and it actually took me a lot longer to build this than I thought. It took me like an hour and 7 minutes. I was expecting like only a half hour, but surprisingly not. You could like take this thing off, I don't know, maybe put Luke Skywalker's thing in there, I don't know. And there's like a lever over here. I'm just gonna put Luke and C-3PO in. Not Obi-Wan, he's kicked out, he's not going in. In all honesty, that Ben Kenobi minifigure is one of the worst minifigures of all time in my personal opinion. It's just, I can't believe they're still using it. We're getting a new set with him. I'm probably gonna sell him after I'm done with my 2018 collection of the Lego sets I got, and put C-3PO in there. There's like three stickers right here, but that's okay. I put them on myself, and yeah, this is basically based on the scene where R2's hiding and Luke gets knocked out and Obi-Wan rescues him from a Tusken Raider. So there's also a rat minifigure as well. So it's the same rat that we've been getting for a while. Nothing exclusive. So So there's the land speeder for you. I almost said Sam for a moment. Oh my god. Now here are my final thoughts on this set. Number one is overpriced with no exclusive pieces or minifigures. And it's just another land speeder, the same one that we got from 2014, exactly the same, maybe just slightly different. It should have been $15, but for some reason they put it to $20 just because it's a Walmart exclusive. And this thing is still on shelves if you want to get it. And it's got some good minifigures except for C-3PO and Obi-Wan. And oh my god, Obi-Wan. Really? And, with Luke and Tusken Raider being the best minifigures from the set, and I'd give it a 7.9 or something like that, or 7.4 out of a 10. Yeah, 7.4 out of a 10. And the overall grade I would give it would be a B-. It's not the worst thing ever, but it definitely could be better. It's a Walmart exclusive, so I'd say hurry up. Pick it up before they're all sold out. This thing's only going to be out for only just a couple other months until 2019 pops up. And I'll see you in the next review. Bye.